I think I did better second half than first half. We just tried our best, trying to win and trying to, because they beat us already more than once. So we just wanted to get this win. We're state champs. We just wanted to get another win.
Yeah. So this loss obviously isn't going to put like a damper on the season or anything, right? You guys are still pretty proud of what you accomplished.
I'm proud that our goal in the beginning of the season was to go to state and win state. And I think we did that. Mm-hmm. And, well, we did do that. Yeah. But I mean, like, we came out hard and it is how it is.
Yeah.
Can you talk about the future with this team? A lot of young girls. You're going to miss Lauren and Ariana, but there's got to be a bright future for you guys, you think?
Yeah, for the people that are coming in and the people that are here now, I think that if we keep working as hard as we did this season, we should be fine. There's no competition for us next year.
Do you feel a little spoiled being a freshman and getting to the state final and being a part of something this special?
No, not really. I think I worked for my spot on the team, and I worked for what I wanted to start and to be able to play in the state. That I think that was my goal was in the beginning of the season. I'm glad I'm here.
How much does that make you guys want to come back and do this again?
It makes me even hungrier just to know that we won already and then came to the League of Champions, we lost. We can do it next year, so I just can't wait till next season.
How much did Ariana and Lauren help you become what you became by the end of the season?
They were our leaders on the team, and know that now that we won't have them next year, it's just a damper. But, I mean, we're going to keep working hard. We're going to have people stepping up to the plate in their spots, but they were a real leader. They pushed us all the way in practice and games. They led our team.
How much are you going to miss them?
Yeah, I'm going to miss them a lot.
Okay. Can you talk about Lauren Moses and how excited you guys are going to be to come back next year? As you got a pretty good, strong group around. Talk about her growing up
year. We've talked for the past, this whole season, how we're going to be good for the next, well, my next year, and then they'll be even good for the next few years because Lauren, she brought so much to this team. Like, that's what our team has been missing since, you know, Chelsea Cole had graduated.
Yeah.
We didn't have no big people really at all. And she finally brought that presence. And then once she gets older and more, and her IQ gets better, she'll be a really good player.
How much better did she become during the season? I saw her earlier in the season, and she wasn't really assertive. And these last 3-4 games, she's really been the woman that you guys need down low.
I think she wasn't ready mentally at the beginning. I guess being a freshman starting, she wasn't really emotionally ready. But with, I think, us teammates encouraging her and building her up and getting her in practice a few times, and I think got her tougher and more emotionally ready. And she just wanted to win, I know, like we all did.
You guys are going to miss Lauren and Ariana,
yeah.
But how excited are you guys to continue what they helped you guys start?
Yeah, them two will be big losses next year because of Lauren's speed and Ariana's, she can see the floor well with the passing. But hopefully we can keep it up and do it for them, but they'll be missed a lot. It'll feel great to keep doing it and hopefully do it again next year. We kind of wasn't ready for it, and we just wasn't, and we didn't play how we should have played and how we could have played, but...
But you've seen that intensity before. You've seen them go on some of them runs.
Yeah, we've seen them twice. This is the third time we played them.
I know, but I mean, you did it, like, even in that second game down at your place.
You guys, I actually wasn't at that game, but...
Oh, you were. That's right. You were sick, weren't you, or something?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, all of a sudden, you're up 10-3, and then all of a sudden, they just go on that run. And,
yeah, like, we had the momentum. We had everything, but I don't know what happened to us. We just, like, died down.
Was it so much what they did or what you didn't do? I mean, what RV didn't do?
I guess you could go both ways. It's, like, what they did and how we didn't respond to it at all. And I think our coach called timeout, but we still didn't even respond to it. And
talk about Lauren Moses as a freshman and how excited you are to have her for 3 more years.
Anybody that sees Lauren play would be excited. She's going to be a tough player. She is a tough player. I mean, she's just only going to get better. She's still 14 years old, still growing into her body, still growing into the toughness of high school basketball, and she just gets better and better. And you know, she's just a coachable kid. I mean, it makes my job so much easier when you can tell a kid one time, do it this way, and she'll just go out there and do it.
How much better was she from December to now? I saw her a couple times, and I thought she was a completely different player.
Oh, God, yeah, she's improved every game, you know, because when Lauren realizes, and I don't even think she has yet, when she realizes how big she can be and how good she can be, The sky's the limit for Lauren. She's gonna have to pick a colleges. You know, in my opinion, I think she's got a good shot to, you know, score over 2,000 points if she can continue on the pace that she's at. You know, she set, she set a record for freshman points, you know, all time. So she's going in the right direction.
So put a little pressure on you to get as good as she can be to help her along.
Sure. I mean, you know. You coach this game to get better, to make kids get better, and you know, winning's always the measuring stick of how good your coach is. Sometimes it's more about building the relationship and really just getting kids to buy into what you believe. I'm fortunate, you know, I've been flexible because I've had different types of kids and different types of teams, and you know, it's forced me to have to change my style. You know, a lot of guys will just do the same thing over and over and over, no matter if they have fast kids, big kids, low. You know, I look at what I get in the beginning of the year and I say, all right, well, this year we're going to be fast and big, so let's push the ball and then let's pound it inside. Then you got kids that can shoot it. So, you know, being able to be flexible makes me a better coach, I think.